Alright guys, I haven't done a decent video for quite a while, so I thought I'd do a tutorial on a gatehouse, and this is a gatehouse that you've seen recently in the thingy build where I was building a spawn for the server. Let's just get on with it. So what's really great about this build is that it uses nothing more than what you can see in my inventory right now. So we've got cobblestone. Shut up. Right, so we're going to start off by planning out, and as you know, I love to use groups of three. So we're going to start off with a gap of three in between the two towers. That's going to be the most important thing, because obviously if you've built the rest of your structure, then buzz off, then you know it's like, oh for goodness sake, good look. Ah, you're so annoying! What is he doing? What are you doing? Oh. So we're going to mark out each side of our little walkway. So I'm going to go 1, 2, 3. Count three blocks and then put another three like that. Now we're going to make a circle like this, so that's one in the corner and then a group of three and then one in the corner. So again, one in the corner, 1, 2, 3, one in the corner, 1, 2, 3, one in the corner, 1, 2, 3, one in the corner, and then we're going to raise this up by one more block, not like that. Next we're going to add steps around the whole thing, so we're going to place three along one side, three along that side, three along that side, three along that side. Let me just do all of these first. And now obviously we need something to put in this space here, so that looks a bit weird, but then, so this is the next best thing we've got. Now the thing is that this looks better when it is looking towards you. For example, if you are looking at it from this angle, it looks better that they are facing diagonal like that, as opposed to looking like that. And because you're more likely to be looking at it front on than from this angle here, we are going to do it so they both face long ways along the building like this. Next we're going to put a rim of stone bricks around the inside of that, just to cover up any gaps that we've created here, and to provide the ceiling for the next bit of building. So now we're going to go up with the cobblestone 5 blocks from this shape here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, oops, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And of course what's really great about this gatehouse design is that you can change so many bits of it and still keep the basic simple structure. You can make it taller, you can make it shorter, you can add these bits on top, you can like completely leave out the bits on top. I mean, I think I actually prefer it without the bits on top, but yeah, I thought I'd do them in anyway. Next we're going to take our stone bricks again and add a layer just around this top layer of cobblestone. So this is the fifth layer up of the cobblestone. Oops, there we go. All around the edge here. And when that's done, we're going to come along with our steps and we're going to, just as we did on the bottom, except we're going to be leaving gaps. Like that, like that, like that. Now the same thing applies to this bit here as it does to here, so you want to mirror that and make it point the same way. There we go. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. There we go. Next we're going to come to the top of the tower and remove this top layer of cobblestone here. Like so. Because that's where our floor is going to go, but we won't worry about that just yet. Because now we're going to add in our battlements, so we're going to go around like this, so one on each side of each three, leaving a gap, so there, 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 and there. Now we're going to take our half step and place them in all the gaps. This will create a nice bit of definition. Obviously this is in default texture pack, but it also adds quite a lot of definition in other texture packs. I will show you this in johnsmiths at the end if I remember. So there we go, there's our two towers. Now we're going to add in our actual floor for the bit that kind of goes in between, I guess you could say. And the way we're going to do this is by making a little doorway shape here. So that's one block above, one block below, and then giving it a floor, so this will come across. And at first this will seem quite low, but it'll look better by the end, I promise. Now we're going to take our stone bricks and bring it along like that. So if you've done all the dimensions right, this should cut this building in half. And to make it look a little bit nicer, you can actually add this ring all the way around. There we go. Now we're going to take our steps and we're going to go underneath like this. And at this point I might just change around some of the steps. For example, if I change this one to face that way, it's actually going to look a lot nicer. So that's probably worth bearing in mind. Probably should have mentioned that at the beginning. Now we need to make this look a little bit more archy, so we're going to remove these three bits here, place them with cobblestone, and then place them like that, stairs like that. There we go. Now for the top of these battlements, we don't really want as high as we did before, so we're just going to use half slabs like that. And there we go, that's pretty much as done as it needs to be, really. I mean, you can leave it like that if you like. I personally kind of prefer that, but now we're going to start and actually do these roof bits. So just before I start, I'm going to put in this floor. This is just going to be wood, but it doesn't really have to be wood, but I think wood does look best. Creates a nice kind of definition against the rest of the stone, because this is quite a stony build. Now we're going to take our fence, and we're going to put the fences on top of all the full blocks, obviously not the half blocks. So around like this. Now we're going to take our steps, and this bit, you're going to have to kind of pause and follow along from here, but we're going to place steps on top of these fences, which is a bit fiddly, so I'll keep misclicking. Along like that. Oopsie. And like that. Now we're going to place wood in all these gaps, and then just get rid of the wood underneath. And then come along with our half blocks and place them on each side of this wood. So like that. This will create a nice shallow lip around the edge. So let's do it on this building. So three along each side. Wood going up in the middle. Remove the bottom pieces. And then place half blocks on each side. Like that. Now we're going to come in and add another two blocks in each corner. These are just going to be for building. Obviously you can remove these as soon as you're done. It's just going to make our life a little bit easier when we're placing our next layer, which is going to be just like the one below, except we're not going to be adding in our half blocks. So we're just going to go along placing three stairs along each side. There you go. And now we're going to do what we did on the layer below and just place blocks in each of these corners to help us out. Now this next layer you can either do like this by placing half blocks and then steps. And that creates a much nicer kind of shallow roof like that, which probably fits the style a little bit more. It looks a little bit more maybe dwarven or a bit more stunted, maybe look better in colder weather climates. But we're going to be building full on medieval style here, so we're going to go ahead and bring these up as full blocks, place half blocks where we did before, and just raise up that top just to create a little bit more of a point like that. So let's do it again. So that's one block in each corner, half block on top of each of those, oops, full block in between each half block with stairs going up, and then one full one on top. So there we go, that's pretty much finished. I'm just going to quickly show you how you can go ahead making a nice flag to go on top. I'm going to use red and black here. So just place a piece of fence, then we're going to go diagonally. So we're going to place, I'll do it all in one color first. So we're going to create this shape here. So when we remove these two blocks, we've got 1, 1, 2, 1, and over here I'll do it in color. So we've got 1, 1, 2, 1, and then we remove those, we've got this shape here. So it's quite a nice little flag design, and I guess that's pretty much it. So if you want to add the interiors for these, then you obviously you'd have to have doors, which would probably go on the inside of your castle so that people can randomly get in. You'd have to fill in one of these walls to put ladders against. So I will actually get out the ladder and throw that ladder all the way up like so, and then you'd need a floor in about this height here. So you've got quite a nice in downstairs here, and you can come upstairs to the second layer, and you can come out to the battlements. And by way of windows, you can kind of add in windows. I mean, if you could just kind of place them in there, or maybe there, or I guess no, that would be too unsymmetrical, so I guess you couldn't do that. Anyway, you can use your imagination for the windows. There's lots of different ways you can do it. Actually, one of the ways that you could do it, which would look quite nice, is like that with a piece of iron in the middle. There we go, I quite like that one. There. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. There'll be more cool videos coming soon. If you're new to my channel, then make sure you subscribe and check out the other stuff I've done, like my Facebook page, like my second channel, Jamziboy, and I will see you guys next time. Oh, just before I go, I totally forgot to show it in johnsmiths texture pack, so here it is in johnsmiths. It doesn't actually look as nice. I don't know, because in this biome, obviously everything's been recolored for the biome colors, so everything's a bit blue, but it really doesn't look as good. I think the reason is because the definition between cobblestone and these bricks isn't really as much as in the default texture pack, so it does look a little bit odd, but it does the job. Anyway, I'll see you guys next time.